There's really no secret about our approach. We keep moving forward, opening up new doors, doing new things, because we're curious. And curiosity keeps leading us down new paths. We're always exploring and experimenting.
Hello, friends. Susie, why do you wait always until the very last second to make some sort of adjustment? You know this is a live show.
I'm coughing.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Imagineers Disney Podcast. I'm your host, Matt, and I'm joined, as always, by my good friend and co-host, Susie. Hey, Susie.
Hey.
Are we alive?
I don't know. We are live. I don't know if I am alive. This cold and this icky weather we've been having in Florida. It's
just... last weekend's monsoon in Florida, and it literally covered the entire state of Florida. This is our inspiration for tonight's episode. We will get to that in a little while. But I know you've been a little under the weather, so hope you are on the mend.
I don't know. I rewatched WandaVision while I was sick. Show is so good.
Just as good as the second. Just as good the second time as it is the first.
It's better. I catch up on so many more little thingies.
Very good. Very good. Yeah. Well, speaking of Disney Plus, that was a nice segue.
I know. What a pro.
Disney Plus Day starts this Friday, so there's like multi-day things going on. Some started earlier this week. Some go throughout the entire weekend. But Disney Plus Day, I guess officially, is Friday. That's when all the big parks stuff happens. So the Walt Disney Company decided that they were going to celebrate all things Disney Plus. So there are things that are going to be made available to you, whether you are a new subscriber to Disney Plus. You can subscribe this month, I believe, for $2.99 if you are a new customer. And if you are a current Disney Plus subscriber, there are some things that are going on as well. We'll start real quick with the Disney parks. So over at Disney World and Disneyland, if you are a Disney Plus subscriber, you have 30 minutes access early to the parks on Friday. And also Disney World and Disneyland Paris will roll out the blue carpet at Walt Disney Studios in Paris and Hollywood Studios in Disney World, and there will be special character interactions. Also, you will have free photos, select photos, and select locations throughout the parks as well. So that's a nice little perk for the day.
Yeah.
Free shipping on new products on Shop Disney. I know that there's some Funko Pop discounts as well for Disney Plus subscribers. There are a whole lot of other things. You can actually go online and look them up. But the one I'm most interested in is the AMC promotion. So you don't have to be a Disney Plus subscriber. You can just go do this. AMC theaters, 200 theaters are participating around the country, where you will be able to go in starting Friday, and I think they're running through the weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and they will be showing random Disney movies.
That is
for
so
$5.
Cool. That is so cool. You're just sitting there. You don't know what you're going to see. We kind of have an idea of some of the possible, you know, the categories of what some of those possible movies may fall into, but we don't know. It's a surprise.
Yes, you do not know what you will be watching at point of purchase. you will know once the projector starts rolling.
Can you imagine sitting there and like Home on the Range comes?
I'd walk out of the theater.
Too.
I would hope they wouldn't do that. I mean, okay, so they are splitting them into like categories. So you're going to have 4 movies a day. There's going to be a Pixar fan favorite. There is going to be a Walt Disney Animation Studios fan favorite. There is going to be just a Disney fan favorite, which I'm assuming is could include some live action. Mary Poppins Returns. Yes.
And my guess is a Mary Poppins movie.
Maybe. And then a Star Wars fan favorite.
Attack of the Clones.
Episode 9.
No.
Would you walk out?
Yes, I would walk out. Are you kidding me? Of course I would walk out. Not on Attack of the Clones. I love that crap.
This is very tempting. So
I don't know. Maybe we should just take off on you don't work on Fridays.
I don't.
Maybe I should just take Friday off. We'll just pay $5 for each different one. Or we'll just pay $5 and sneak into multiple showings and see what they are.
Yeah. So it'll be interesting to see what they pull out for this.
Yeah it seems so Disney does know how to pull out the stops for important days.
Ouch.
Still a little bitter. A little bit bitter.
October 1st still stings.
Yeah.
Anyway, to cheer you up, there are more things coming. Like Candlelight Processional.
Yay!
Candlelight Processional is back. It is still going to be modified. They are not doing the high school and community choirs this year. It's all going to be internal. So I think they'll still have a full choir, but it just won't include choirs from other communities around the state, around the country, whatever. So
it's a happy middle nice ground. Compromise. We need it. Yeah.
So they have announced the, where did it go here? There we go. Got the list. They announced the full list of narrators for this year. I'm just going to briefly go over that real quick. So Candlelight Processional will run November 26th through December 30th this year. And there are some new names to the list. We do have some names that are not on the list that would typically be staples of this event. So November 26th through the 28th, Ali'i Crivello, Moana, is going to be narrating. November 29th through December 1st, Cheetah Rivera. December 2nd through December 4th, Jodie Benson. December 5th through December 7th, Alton Fitzgerald White. December 8th through the 10th, Bart Millard. December 11th through the 13th, Lisa Ling. December 14th through the 16th, Andy Garcia. December 17th through the 19th, Anna Gasteyer. December 20th through the 22nd, Courtney B. Vance. The 23rd through the 25th, Stephen Curtis Chapman. December 26th through the 28th, Blair Underwood. And wrapping out Candlelight Processional this year, December 29th through the 30th, Mr. Pat Sajak. So, nice list of celebrity narrators for this year. I'm looking forward to hopefully going down for at least one of these performances. So we will see.
You know what Pat Sajak's favorite Christmas carol is?
I feel like there's a joke coming on.
I mean, there is. I don't think it's not funny, but
White Christmas?
No.
No.
Noel. No. Because Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we're going to go ahead and do a special shout out to all the people who are still somehow tuning in live to watch this tonight. Alex Week says, love the CCR pre-show. Thank you.
It made me laugh. I like this. I like being surprised when you change our pre-show music.
Yep. I've started getting into the habit when we have specially themed shows that I try to match music with the theme. So yeah. It's always fun seeing Susie's reaction to it off off camera when this she hears the music play.
Because I know what we're talking about, but like I forgot for a second. So when I heard it, I was like, oh my gosh. But the yeah, the first one you did was September.
Yes.
September 21st. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Good times. Our good friend Michael says, just finished watching the latest Patreon video. Fanboy Expo looked fun.
Yes. Haven't seen it yet.
I posted it.
I got to see that. I
wasn't even able to post everything because I had to keep it under 20 minutes.
But did you like that? I tried to get Matt a lot of content too, just because he couldn't be there, because there were some really cool moments with the celebrities. And
it was just so, it was hard to hear some of it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
It's okay. I pulled some good clips. So if you are a patron, you can go check that out. So
if you're a patron and check it out, you may stop being a patron. I don't remember all the things I said on that camera.
Our good friend, a Swansea Searcher. Hello, Imagineers friends. Hello, buddy. Thank you for watching. Alex also commented, back to our regularly scheduled Tuesday programming post-World Series. That's right, sir.
Congratulations, Braves, Matt.
My Atlanta Braves have improbable odds won the World Series.
Oh, you should have gone to Disney this past week. I was actually at Disney when the Cubs won their World Series. We just happened to be there at the same time, and so we got to see the parade. I guess they won't do that with COVID.
I didn't hear of any of them being down there, but I could be wrong. They had a big parade on Friday through Atlanta.
Yeah, and that bus was – did you see that bus? It was just flying.
Yeah, it was going pretty fast. But, yes, the Braves won. A little statistical information for anyone that cares. At the All-Star break, so if you're not familiar with baseball, if you don't watch baseball, the All-Star break is like the middle of the season. They take a few days off. They have the All-Star game, home run derby. At the All-Star break, the Braves' chances of winning the World Series was like 0.03% or 0.3%. Of course, that's actually the same now that I think about
it. No, those are different things. 0.03.
Oh, yeah, yeah. 0.3 are different. Yeah. I think it was 0.03. I think it was 0.03%. So, yeah.
Wow.
Against all odds.
Wow. There's some Disney magic jokes we can make there.
We could.
They reached out and made their own magic, according to our new nighttime show. Hey, Claire.
Claire Brown. Hey, Claire. Hey. Good to see you. Let's see here. Turner says, Southwest Airlines is having a sweepstakes to win a Disney trip for four. Not sure if you guys mentioned this past episodes, but I'm sure viewers would love to know. Yes. There are a lot of, like,
there's a lot of promos going on right now.
Promos going on. Not just for Disney, just all over the place. I'm seeing contests for everything. So if you see those, 100% enter in to win, because we can't.
Yeah.
We are disqualified.
Not that I'd win anyway. I'd never win anything like that in my life.
Yeah. Oh, let's see here. I'm just bumping through some of these. Candlelight. Swansea says, I locked in his candlelight for next month. Let's see. One, boom, 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 boom. Okay, that's it. All right. Let's get into tonight's episode topic. And that is, if you caught the pre-show, I played some Creedence Clearwater Revival. Have you ever seen the rain? And that's because we are going to talk about how to prepare for rainy days at Disney World. So we actually kind of touched on this a little bit in last week's episode when I think both of us mentioned, you know, bring a poncho or a rain jacket. And we're kind of going to really dive into this a little bit, because this may be something that people overlook when planning their Disney World trip, they don't think about it being Florida, and that for the months of May, June, July, August, September, October-ish, there's a good chance, especially in those summer months, that you are going to experience some sort of rain event, storm event on any given day of your trip.
I mean, any given day of the trip, I would say almost any time of the year when we get, like, we had a nor'easter come through last week. It was just disgusting. So we have cold rainy days. We have hot, icky, humid rainy days. Always, of course, look at like a weather forecast for your trip. I always, though, just pack for at least one worst case scenario day. So even if I'm traveling in the summer, I always bring like jeans. I always bring a jacket just because you never know. Mm-hmm. So same with the rain. You just never know. So you should always have that as a backup option.
Yeah, absolutely. So there are a lot of clothing things that I think can help with this. So, you know, we talked about the ponchos. Mm-hmm. Do not buy ponchos in the park. Bring your own. You can go get better ones from Walmart or Academy Sports or Dick's Sporting Goods, Bass Pro Shop. Those are going to have the nicer rain jackets and ponchos. I'm still mourning the death of mine that is in my closet and that I can never wear again.
I'm literally looking at my Disney rain jacket right now because I had to have it out from last weekend when I had to take Copper out. So I wore it then. It's come in handy. Not to rub it in your face. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. Claire says, unpopular opinion, but Florida rain is the best.
Well,
I haven't ever thought of that before.
Maybe it's because you're already at Disney, so it can't get better. Or Disney maybe rain? Because... Remember when they used to have a rain parade?
Oh, well, then maybe we'll mention that in some things to do.
Well, I didn't have it on my list because I don't know now with everything going on.
So Claire is from Ireland.
She says, "Try a constant
sprinkle in Ireland."
I was wondering if it was a reference to the weather she has over there. Yeah, no, when it rains in Florida, it rains.
Yeah. So we had some really bad weather here last weekend, and it's just not normal. It's normally not that bad. It is uncommon to have entire days where it does not stop raining.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what we experienced this past weekend. We had one really long day of rain, and then it actually got, for Florida, pretty chilly. So, the elements, especially getting closer to, I would say November, December, January, February, you have the potential of running into some cooler weather at Disney World as well. I don't know if we'll ever do an episode on cold weather at Disney World, but it can happen. So we're just going to focus on the rain side. So ponchos and rain jackets. I would say extra socks, like more socks than you would have. I would say at least a couple, just in case you do run into a spot where you're in a park and it's rained really hard and there's standing water.
Mm-hmm.
Your shoes are going to get wet. Your socks are going to get wet. And you don't want to be walking in those soaked socks for the entire day. So bring an extra pair of socks, maybe pack it in your bag, your park bag.
Yeah. I have a flip side, pun intended, like another twist on that. If you know it's going to rain, bring flip-flops or bring Crocs or something like Crocs? You don't like Crocs?
I've never owned a pair. I don't know.
I freaking love Crocs. They are so comfortable. That's what I walk Copper in sometimes. When we go on longer walks, I wear tennis shoes. I just slide them on and they're so comfy. They have cute ones too now. They're not all the like rectangle things with the holes. I have a pair that look like, I have like garden shoe ones. I have some that look like Mary Jane's, which are like a little nicer Crocs, but still like a water shoe thing.
Yeah.
I love a good pair of Crocs.
Yep. Never owned a pair. I think they look funny. But
You're literally wearing a Country Bear t-shirt and you're concerned about like funny looking things.
You don't know I'm wearing a Country Bear t-shirt. You can't see it.
I saw part of it earlier. You adjusted. Oh, aren't okay, you wearing fine. A Big Al shirt?
You caught me. I'm wearing the Country Bear shirt. Wearing Big Al.
Yeah. Anyway. It's not mock Crocs. I love Crocs. But no, you see what I mean? Especially during the summer. If you just don't want to deal with the wet tennis shoe situation, I've done this before and just bring, but I'm also a Floridian and like, I don't care. But Walmart sells like 99, literally like 99 cent flip flops. So maybe stop by Walmart at the beginning of your trip and just pick up a pair of really crappy flip flops in case you need to make a mad dash through the rain.
Claire also says Crocs are the bomb, especially those Lightning McQueen ones. They make you so fast.
Ka-chow.
Ka-chow. Samantha says, agreed, Florida rain is the best. I only have Colorado rain, which is no.
Can't relate.
Swansea says, Wonder Bread bags over your socks. It's a New England thing.
I'm feeling very confident tonight in being a Floridian for some reason. Everyone else sounds really terrible.
We got another comment. Last time I was there, it was about 60 degrees. I was laughing because they had gloves set out at all the souvenir shops.
That's so cold.
60 degrees is comfortable. That's like the perfect day.
As a low, when I'm in my cabin at Fort Wilderness, up in my sweatshirt and a blanket.
If 60 degrees is the low, that means it's going to be like in the 80s. Yes. You need the lows to be in like the mid 50s to where it'll push up to like 70, 75. Where it's not cold enough to wear a jacket, but not hot either. It's like perfect.
You sound like that girl in Miss Congeniality right now, where she's describing the perfect date, and it's like whatever in April because you just need a light jacket. No, that's too cold.
Yeah. Alex says Matt's face with Crocs looks like me when someone tries to explain Marvel to me.
Oh, Alex, then don't go see the Eternals. Because that's all you'll do the whole time is to be like, because that's
Susie has seen the Eternals. I have not yet, so
it's okay.
No. Anyway, but anyway,
back to the rain. Well,
Swansea says, you know, bringing things to, I guess, keep the socks in, like Wonder Bread bags. I would put them in my backpack, but
yeah.
I think there are other things, but clothing items. So we've talked about rain jackets and socks. I think breathable material in general, especially in the summer, is going to benefit you so that if it rains and you get caught in it, you're not wearing like this heavy cotton t-shirt and then you walk into the queue, into any pretty much any indoor queue at Disney World and it's freezing cold. And then you feel worse.
Yeah.
So breathable material, socks, rain jackets, any other clothing items you want to mention or is that about it?
Not clothing. I do have a few other items that you may want to bring though for the rain.
Okay.
If you have a stroller or a scooter, bringing a cover for those.
Very good.
Thank you. What a travel agent. And then this is something I actually just bring this on a lot of my trips in general. I just bring Ziploc bags because you never know. I also normally put my toiletries in Ziploc bags because I've had things burst and like get on clothes and that's really fun. But Ziploc bags for things like, you know, like guys for your phone, if it's going to be raining and you just have a pocket, I don't know, anything that you don't want to get wet, just pop in as a black bag.
Yeah. That was on my list too, because of the rain. This actually happened to me when I did the Parkeology challenge. So the morning, it rained a whole lot. Like, it was a very, very rainy morning. And I actually had my cell phone in my rain jacket, but moisture still wound up in that pocket. And I had charging issues until I could really dry out the phone. So,
yeah.
Yeah, bring some like sandwich bags or something, Ziploc bags, to keep your electronic devices, anything that you want dry inside the bag that you have. So,
yeah.
Got some more comments. Let's see. Elena, good to see Elena. Classic tourist look of a poncho is great. Yes.
It's like that defeated hunch with the poncho.
Swansea says, wicking shirts dry super fast. Yes, yes. And Claire says, me and my poncho and Crocs trying to look local. Yeah, there's a lot of...
Oh, I love the Croc love.
There's a lot of characters. So.
But when you're talking about breathable material, that's why those disposable, icky ponchos are... the worst, they stick to you.
Ooh, yeah.
And it makes it so much hotter. And it's just literally like wrapping yourself in like saran wrap. It's horrible.
Yeah. So, okay. So we've gone over the clothing items. We've gone over Ziploc bags and things. Is there anything else? Is there anything else you had on preparation?
No, not for preparation.
Okay, yeah, that was the end of my list for preparation. So what happens if it actually rains? Well, if rain is in your forecast, I'm going to recommend that you get to the park as early as possible and get as much in as possible before that weather rolls in.
Yeah.
Because odds are it's going to be short, but it's going to be a lot. Mm-hmm. And you know, the thing is, Disney World is so big that it can be raining in one park and not raining in another.
This is true.
So sometimes you just don't know. But the earlier you are in the park, you know, typically those storms are going to happen in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. So get as much done as you can in the morning. And then if the weather starts getting bad or threatening, because it's not just rain, it's also lightning. And if
is what will shut the attractions down, and wind, by the way, I would say for things like the Skyliner too, there's, you know, going to be certain limitations, but yeah, I mean, I've ridden outdoor rides in the rain before. It's kind of fun. I mean, it hurts a little bit.
Yeah.
But the lightning is your problem. Yeah. And Central Florida is literally like lightning capital USA. So right. That's where you get, you have your problem. What do you think is the best park? If you had a day where it just, like we had this weekend, where it's just nonstop rain, which park do you think is the best?
Well,
I have an answer, but I'm not sure.
So, I mean, for the sheer amount of indoor attractions in Magic Kingdom, I think. Yeah. I mean, Pirates, Buzz Lightyear, Space Mountain,
Haunted Mansion, Small World.
Now you have to get there. You have to get there. But also there are things like the Enchanted Tiki Room. Mm-hmm. There are things like the Country Bear Jamboree or Carousel of Progress that may actually be long enough to where, you know, it starts raining, you go in, you see that show, and then you come out and it's done.
Yeah.
Not all the time, but sometime.
Yeah, I was stuck between Magic Kingdom, but then I got to thinking, like, with the exception of basically Slinky Dog Dash, everything at Hollywood Studios is inside.
I don't know if they would... I'm trying to think. Yeah.
I know. And they have a lot of show when everything's up and running, in theory, there are quite a few shows there too. But that, I think that's the big thing, is you got to go somewhere where there are inside shows that are going to take between sitting down the actual show and leaving 30 to 40 minutes, depending on how early they let you get there and sit.
Yeah, Hollywood has some options. So Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, Toy Story Mania, Smuggler's Run, Rise of the Resistance, the Frozen sing-along, I think.
And you can line up for that very early.
And that can eat a good chunk of time. I don't know if they would do Beauty and the Beast, since part of it is an outdoor.
They have in the past, because I've done it. Now, not when it's like torrential, but when it is enough that you can hear it while you're sitting under, where you hear it on the roof. But yeah, not like a monsoon like this weekend.
Yeah. So yeah, I think Hollywood would be my second option. But Animal Kingdom is tough, and Epcot is tough, since there's just a lot of open space.
Well, that's the thing with Epcot. If it's like a normal Florida storm, you just find a shop in World Showcase and hunker down. Like, you can shop in China and Japan for like a half hour. They're huge stores.
Go watch The American Adventure.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, there are options in each park, but I think Animal Kingdom would have the fewest.
Yeah. So that may be one that you know, if you know it's going to rain, either avoid it, or if you have a park hopper, go do Animal Kingdom in the morning and like hop somewhere else in the afternoon when the rain comes.
I'm going to throw out an idea.
Okay.
So as long as there isn't lightning and you have a Park Hopper Plus pass, consider a water park, because what is rain going to do? You're already wet.
What is rain but a pool perseverance?
You've been watching way too much WandaVision this past week. So I think the water parks could work. I think, no, Disney Springs would not be a good option.
Well, I had a note of, I mean, you can go see a movie at Disney Springs.
Ah, yeah, there you go.
And specifically, I recommend the dine-in side.
Mm-hmm.
That is so much fun. You get a little button, you get a menu, and you like choose what you want. And you have an attendant that comes, you know, like when you push your little buzzer during the movie, if you want more food or refill on your drink. And then just like, yeah, go get another ticket and see another movie and spend the afternoon doing that.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think that's a great idea. I would also throw out Splitsville.
Mm-hmm.
Splitsville, I think, could be an option for you at Disney Springs if you want to go bowling.
Are we still in Disney Springs?
Sure we are.
Because there's a new Cirque du Soleil show coming.
I was about to say. Now, obviously, I think that's going to be specific times of the day.
Sure.
And that's kind of an expensive last second option,
but let's say you see in the forecast and you don't want to risk it one day, and maybe you decide to make that your, like, you know, rest day, and you can't go to the pool, go see, what is it, Drawn to Life?
Yeah,
there you go.
Yep. Yeah, I think that'd be good. Let's see here. Claire says swimming in the rain is more fun anyway. Swansea says water parks on rain days.
So we are really like.
He beat me.
Why
beat
is me everyone it? Like this? I don't, but that's because I'm pale. So when I get to go to the pool, that's when I get to get, you know, a smidgen of a shade darker. So I like to go to the pool when I can get sun.
Oh, yeah, and Swansea also brings up a good point. There's an Animal Kingdom attraction. As long as there's no lightning, you can do Kali River Rapids.
Crappy River Rapids. You can do that on any day, and it'll basically be like you walked around in the rain. Speaking of last-minute things, a lot of people tend to, when it starts to rain, like exit the park and mm-hmm. think that their day is ruined. Don't do that. Stay, because like we said, it normally doesn't last too terribly long. Just pull up radar on your phone and keep track of it. look for canceled dining reservations.
Yes, that is a great
time. Because that is a great time to snag something up when some coward is intimidated by a little bit of rain in Florida.
Let's see. We got a question. Do they only close rides for lightning? I mean, obviously the indoor ones.
Right, those are fine.
Barring electrical problems, but
which I don't think that would happen. I feel like Disney has like a couple generators at least.
I've ridden Slinky Dog in the rain. I wouldn't call it fun.
Yeah, I've done Seven Dwarves in the rain.
I think if it's like drizzling, they will keep it running. But if it's like pouring, I think they might shut it down. I don't think they would run it when it's super, super heavy rain.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. But lightning for sure. Or power outages. Computer malfunctions due to lightning.
Could you imagine like being at Disney World and like power goes out?
Well, one of the things, so for those of you who are kind of new to the podcast, it's been 2 years. It has been 2 years since my parkeology attempt.
Oh my gosh. Has it really?
It's been 2 years.
Well, yeah, because COVID wiped out an entire year. Holy crap. Oh my gosh.
That's crazy. So I did a charity event for our good friends over at Funding Love. They're an adoption nonprofit. Some friends from Travelmation. And I raised money for Funding Love by attempting to do the Parkeology Challenge, which is riding every single ride at Disney World in one day. And closed attractions that are down for maintenance don't count. So good to go there. But I didn't quite make it. I got 45 of 47. And part of it was due to just bad luck. It rained in the morning, so they didn't do the Main Street vehicles. And I did not ride the Speedway. I think that was it. But Seven Dwarfs Mine Train had some downtime in the morning because it was storming so bad. It was raining so bad. I guess they had a computer malfunction or whatever. Really? And it was down. It was down for like 3 hours. So,
oh my gosh,
that killed me, but I almost made it. Almost made it.
You would have done it if it hadn't been for the weather then.
Had it not been for the weather, I would have made it.
Gosh, can you imagine trying to do that now, though, with more attractions, no fast passes?
So I recently just had somebody ask me if I would do it again. And I would do it again, but it's kind of impossible to do it right now with the way that park hopping is set up. You can only park hop starting at 2. And yeah. I was park hopping because, I mean, I knocked out Hollywood Studios in an hour and a half. And then what went to Magic Kingdom. So
that's crazy.
You can't do that right now. So I don't even think it's physically possible to get a on it.
And like with park reservations and how they have the Lightning Lane, everything, Genie Plus. Yeah, that's going to be a logistical nightmare.
Yeah. I feel like you have more of a chance of doing it with Genie Plus now.
What I'm hearing though with the Genie is once you make a reservation, you're stuck with it unless you can't modify it. You have to cancel it. And then if that other time that you saw popped up is not there, now you're out the one you've already canceled. So unlike dining where you can just look and modify, you have to cancel.
So I know
it's going to make a new one.
I know it's close to being feasible because there was a gentleman who did the Parkeology Challenge on two days in a row. He did Disneyland and California Adventure in one day, hopped on a flight.
No, oh my gosh.
He made the red eye from LA to Orlando and then did Disney World the very next day. So
even his travel agent.
So Disneyland had Max Pass at the time, so it was similar. So I think it can be done. Anyway, I wanted to die at the end of that day. Like the next day, I was so sore.
You didn't want to get on a red eye?
No, because I went for like 16 hours, 16 straight hours. So it was insane.
I've done that before in one park. I mean, everyone's done the like rope drop to park close, but like having to go from park to park, that's too much stress.
Anyway, we've gotten way off on this. So
yeah, so anyway. That's the rain.
The rain messed everything up. So don't let the rain be a damper on your trip, because
don't let it rain on your parade.
Oh, speaking of parades and rain, you have I forget the official title of it. Is it the Rainy Day Parade?
I think it's the Rainy Day Parade. That's what I was gonna say. It's cute. I don't know if it still exists though.
I don't know. I have only seen it once.
Yeah.
The stars have to align for you to actually see it. And again, I haven't heard of it running since COVID pandemic stuff, but it would not surprise me if they still had it.
Because, I don't know.
I mean, it's essentially a cavalcade.
It's basically,
what happens is if there is scheduled rain, or if the rain is like just finished, but there's not enough time to pull out the big floats for Festival of Fantasy, they will pull out the Rainy Day Cavalcade. And it's essentially some smaller vehicles that come out with a handful of characters, Mickey, Minnie, Donald, and then the dancers that are typically in Festival of Fantasy. They're in like rain jackets, like bright yellow rain jackets.
It's really cute. Cool.
Yep. Okay. I want to point this comment out. Thank you so much. To not embarrass Matt in the future, because I will be tuning in from now on, my name is pronounced like so. Krina. Got it. Krina, thank you so much for watching.
Not forget.
You've been providing some very fun comments over the past few weeks, so we are glad you have joined us. So
yes, yay.
Krina, got it. Thank you to all who comment during the show.
We're all so chatty tonight.
Yeah, everybody's like real chatty. So
I feel like we should just sit back one day and like not have a topic and just let you guys talk. Which is basically what Discord is.
So yeah, we're pretty much done with this topic. I hope you've enjoyed talking about how to best prepare for rain for Disney World. But we would love to continue the chat throughout the week with you guys. We have our Discord channel where we watch movies every Friday night, and we'll occasionally talk about other Disney topics throughout the week. So if there is something you want to talk about, we've basically set up our Discord channel where there's like little mini topic chats. So we have like one for Disney World, Disneyland, Disney Cruise Line, Marvel, Star Wars, Disney memes. So if you want to post something and start a conversation about it, please do so. Come join us. And then on Friday nights, we watch our weekly movies. We had a great time last week as we watched The Sandlot.
We did.
That was a lot of fun. That was a lot of fun. One of the great baseball movies. We're going to do one more sports movie. We were kind of in a sports mood. So this coming Friday, we'll be watching Miracle. And if you've never seen Miracle, it is about the 1980 U.S. men's Olympic hockey team. And I don't know. Should I spoil? I don't want to spoil.
Well, the movie's called Miracle.
But, yeah, I guess so. Anyway, one of the greatest sports moments of the 20th century. And it's actually a really great movie. Really great movie. So we're going to watch that this Friday. And what else were we going to say? There was other things too. Oh, Patreon. Yes.
Oh, Patreon.
We do special videos each month with our patrons. So for as little as $2 a month, you can get access to that exclusive content posted. It was a little late and I apologize for that. But Susie's video from Fanboy is up and live on our Patreon. So come check us out, patreon.com/Imagineers. And if you become a patron, you automatically get entered into our monthly drawings for our prizes. And I actually heard back from all of our winners this past month. So I will be drawing those out this week. So we got the posters ready to go, and those will be coming to you soon. And I didn't tell Susie this. So we also have once a month, we have chats with our top tier patrons. And I may have accidentally sent out the invite to all of our patrons. Tonight from 9 until 9:45, if you're a patron, come join us. We will chat with you, whatever you want to talk about. So the floor is yours. If it's you want to talk about movies, or if you want to talk about Disney World, or if you have travel questions, we will sit down with you and talk about whatever you want to talk about for 45 minutes. So come join us.
It is very relaxed. Our top tier patrons know that, and we have to do a catch up with them. So they will get another chat this month anyway, because we didn't do to cancel October. yeah, it's very informal.
Yeah, but we have a good time.
Oh, always.
Cool.
This is so fun.
Yes, it is. So we appreciate you guys. Thank you so much, as always, for watching and engaging with us during the live show. We have appreciated your comments this evening. It's been a blast. And if you have enjoyed listening to the episode and haven't subscribed to the podcast, please do so by going to Apple Podcasts. And especially if it's Apple Podcasts, leave us a review. Let us know what you love about the show. And you can also check us out on other podcast platforms as well. Google Podcasts, Spotify, wherever you like to listen to the podcast. You can find us by searching for the Imagineers Disney Podcast. Well, I think that is going to do it for this week's episode. Again, thank you so much for listening and watching. And we look forward to coming at you again with another episode next week. But until then, friends, remember, if you can dream it, you can do it. Bye-bye.
There's really no secret about our approach. We keep moving forward, opening up new doors, doing new things, because we're curious. And curiosity keeps leading us down new paths. We're always exploring and experimenting.